Hello, my name is Lindsay Sharon, and I teach at Ensign Intermediate School in Newport Beach, California. Daybreak. For most people, the start of a new day is a pleasant experience. When you don't completely close your curtains, the light that streams in as the sun begins to rise represents positivity and the chance to start anew. But on more days than I would like to mention, the sun that streams in makes me want to cower under the covers. You see, I deal with depression. After I got the diagnosis, even my mom questioned it. She asked, "But you're so well off, and your husband is a saint. How can you feel this way?" And it's true. Even now, there are times when I still feel guilty about it, though I know I shouldn't. This is not a choice I've made. I worry that most people are judging me when I discuss this, because it's true. I do have an incredible husband who supports me in everything I do. And I have two rambunctious golden retrievers that always greet me at the door with love and affection. And I have a beautiful home, and I work at a wonderful school that I feel privileged to work at. Yet I cannot shake the feelings that consume me some days. Robin Williams once said, "I think the saddest people always try their hardest to make people happy, because they know what it's like to feel absolutely worthless." It's such a truth. I'm the activity director at my school site, and I'm the first one to say hi in the hallways. I put on dances and assemblies, and I try to make students and staff members feel welcome on our campus, even if it feels like I'm dragging around a 150-pound anchor behind me, or if I'm melting away inside. I do not want to hide this anymore. This is a part of me, and I'll never be able to heal and work on becoming whole again unless I talk about this. After years of trying to stand on wobbly legs, I want to stand tall once more. I do not want to feel like two different people. I want to feel comfortable in my own skin again. And that is why, after trying a medication that did not help me, I am seeing a psychologist regularly. I am making time for myself, and yoga has become a practice that helps me swim above the waves instead of drowning in them. Each day, I'm working a little more on accepting that this is not my fault and that this is a disease. For I know that this is the only way I will once again be able to reach for the sun instead of cowering away from it. If you are hurting, please seek help. You should not feel ashamed, and you are not alone. Find a sport, hobby, or practice that helps you find your way toward the light. And remember to treat everyone you meet with kindness, for you never know the troubles that they may be dealing with. Thank you.